Anthony Manche was a 20-year-old student, the son of Charles and grandson of Lorenzo, both served as medical officers of the Malta Garrison. He was a university student who graduated as a doctor. Later in his life, he was appointed vice-chancellor and rector of the University of Malta. This part of the evidence he gave in front of the June Disturbance Commission.
More shots followed from the same direction. As before, I am perfectly certain that no firing took place from where I was, or from the balconies, or windows, above or in front of me either. Before or after the shots which came from the directions of where the soldiers were. A man who had taken cover in the door next to me. He's dead, sir, look, he's dead. I looked all around, and as there were people still running in front of me, I could not see the dead man he mentioned. But when the last rows, about 12 rows, had not passed yet, I saw a man with a face downward in the middle of the road, lying motionless on the floor. The rest of the mob ran by him without throttling on him. At first, I thought he was playing a trick, as I could never believe that the troops were actually firing at the mob. But to my great astonishment, on peeping from the place of cover over the clean road, I saw another black figure lying motionless without a stretched arm near the letterbox. Just a few yards from the soldiers. I was convinced that the man lying in the middle of the street was not jesting. On looking again, I saw the soldiers lined across the road, an officer barehanded and with the stick lifted in his right hand. Seemed to be telling something to a soldier in the second row. The office was still on the side of where the letterbox is. The man who was standing and thinking in the aiming position. I cannot tell exactly in what position the soldier in the front row next to the officer was, but the man on the right of the soldier was kneeling and with his rifle in the aiming position. The next man on the right of his side was And I saw him open and close his bolt. Evidently the act of reloading, I was impressed by the group and I had just described that do. Not remembering of rather knowing what the other soldiers were doing, for I got this horrid scene just as at a glance. This excitement in me was so great when I realized that the man lying on the floor had been shot, that disregarding the danger of being shot, I immediately left my cover and stepped forward into the middle of the road to go and help the unfortunate man. Another man had just reached him when I got him. The position in which he was lying showed that he had been running when he had shot. He was lifted to be in a sitting position, and I could see a gush of blood flowing from the left side of his forehead and something about an inch long hanging out of the wound, which looked like a brain to me. He showed no signs of life.